say that. Everybody say
it. It's your demon. It's your demon.
What up, Rob? What up, what up? Damn, I hope they don't mess with my line. We out here. We out here. It's Martin Luther King Day, y'all. It's Martin Luther King Day. I'm finna try to find a mask, man.
What?
A mask. Peace, peace, peace. What up, what up?
I'm trying to show you my ticket I got.
Oh, hell.
You scared me?
Uh-uh.
Did I tell you?
What'd you get a ticket for?
I paid that mayor a visit at 1 in the morning. When this set up. We got 4 weeks on. I let him know that it's not real nice. I blame protesters for broken windows. That should have been a bird, anything. That's bullshit. That ain't fair. 8 cop cars, 16 cops came for me. $111 ticket.
That ain't bad.
No. He said, you can do it, just not after 11.
Oh, the noise ordinance? It was a noise, okay.
I don't know.
So just to show, they gave me this damn bikini mask. But just to show you something, right? This is Red Arrow Park, where Dontre Hamilton was killed on Martin Luther King Day, and look what they're doing. Yeah, nice ice skating on Martin Luther King Day. Martin Luther King Day. Great. Well, you know, all skating matters, I guess. All ice activities matters. What's up? What's up? What up? What up?
How are you?
All right.
Being good. I'm dying.
Not at the moment.
I was dying. I'm
yeah.
Dying.
This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to, you know. Hello, hello.
Hey,
how you doing? I'm all right.
Hey, I need you to, I'm going to hit you up on Messenger.
Okay.
I got some for you.
Okay. Can you grab me another mask out of the car? They in them envelopes in that box.
Who do we have to wear?
I just hope that they don't, mess with my life because of this music. Hey, how you doing?
How are you?
I'm all right. We are downtown Milwaukee, right across from City Hall. City Hall is right there.
If it's over, you're done.
Hey man, justice for Andre Nicholson too.
One guy who said if you bring it up high enough, right?
Justice for Andre Nicholson too.
Yeah.
She's right here. You already know that's my little homie. I'm trying to get a mask on. Okay, what I may do is what was that poem? That poem was that part of the Martin Luther King thing, or was that for something different?
Wait, what?
The poem that you did that was on, like, the live stream. Was that for the Martin Luther King thing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow, I
can't. I can't imagine. And he just had,
you know what? I'm finna fold this a couple times and then tie it on my face. Thank you. You got this off the floor.
You said they were where?
In the box, in the envelopes.
Hey, beautiful.
Here, you just take that back. Here, just, here you go.
Hello, people.
Next time, just inbox me. If I got time to come grab you, I will.
Hey, you ain't never said you got to answer me about that.
I did. Well,
are you going to or not? Bro?
Yeah, I can.
What's happening, live?
Hey, man, tell me what we out here for, man. You know what I'm saying? Man. Take it.
We out here to celebrate the life of Martin Luther King, man, and still stand for what we standing for, man, which is justice, man. We at Dontre Hamilton Park. It's very disrespectful that they skate.
And yeah, I just went over there and saw that. That's
it's
what they
very disrespectful that they
that's
skate.
What they, that's what they choose to do with their time on MLK Day. You know.
But we got a good crowd out here, man.
How far are we going?
Not too far.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, man, we gonna.
Hey, you got a round picked out? You know where you're going?
Okay. Why you wanna hit some more?
You should hit there. Because you didn't know I'm here tomorrow, right?
I was going to go to the Pizza, Wisconsin.
Pizza, Wisconsin.
It's like the federal building or something, ain't it?
On 5th? No, the federal building is back this way.
Well, we can go this way then.
Okay. What do you think if MLK was alive today? If MLK was alive today, I honestly don't think. You know what? I can't say that because had he have lived, had people like him and Malcolm and all of them lived, I think we would be a lot further than what we are now. I think by losing them, we lost a lot of that fight. We lost a lot of why we out here. We lost good leadership and all of that matter. So if they were just alive today, I don't think they would have to be disappointed or anything of that nature because we would have maintained their leadership and had, you know, I think we would have been a lot better off because Malcolm was starting to change himself and his message and how he did things, and so was Martin. So they were starting to meet each other in the middle. And I think that balance of militancy, of self-protection, self-preservation, alongside the growth was good, bro.
Man, you already know.
Alongside the message of nonviolence and advocacy and all of that, that would have been a good balance in messaging and bringing two different sides together for one cause. Because everybody, what up? Hey man, I gotta get one of these hoodies, man. Them two crispy.
He's got the Martin Luther King, mine's got the Malcolm X card on the back.
Hey man. So we are here to support the young people today. That's one of the great things about what we're doing right now. Can't expect them to care, y'all. Hey man, listen, everybody should care. They say all lives matter. That means if there's an injustice as an American, if they cared about everybody being Americans, if they thought everything was equal and nothing was wrong, that's one thing. But they know that's not true. So you cannot say that we are all Americans, we should all be on the same fight, the same cause, and not care about what's happening with another group of people who are also American. That is a message and a mindset that is contradictory to what you are saying. You cannot say that we have freedom of speech, but be against somebody's freedom of speech and want everybody to adhere to yours. You cannot say these things. So you can't expect them to care, because these are the principles they claim to live by. And if you are claiming to live by some principles, we have to hold you accountable, and we have to hold you to what you say your words are. So the very fabric of what this nation is supposed to stand on, when they say they fought for your freedom of speech, when they say they fought for this and gave you that, then you're supposed to be able to live, breathe, and exist as the same as they are. But you got people who literally their existence is to ensure and to instill that you should not be able to do what they can do, that you should not have what they have, that you should not be considered human, humane, civil, people, 100% of a human being as they are. So they do have to care. They should very much fucking care that Martin Luther King is not with us no more, because we didn't kill him. I should very much so take very much so pride in an American who had a very substantial history, and why so many people believe in equality and unity and, you know, the mixing of cultures and unity and all that kind of stuff. He was that message. You know, even those ones who hate us, when they got something to say, guess who they quote? They quote Martin Luther King, right? You want to quote Martin Luther King back to us, right? So why are you out here skating on the day of his celebration with not a care in the world? That's a conflicting thing. We ain't out here skating. We out here in the damn cold, getting ready to walk around and apparently bring them back to the realization that Martin Luther King's life mattered, right? He's part of the all lives that matter, right? Okay then. Listen, man, it's 2021. And like I said, in 2020, it's time over to just let stuff pass. It's time over to give people excuses. It's time over to say, well, no, we ain't got to worry about them. No, we do have to worry about them. They are running around setting us 50 plus years back. We cannot progress. We cannot move forward with people who are continuously going out every day, setting us back intentionally. There cannot be no progress in this nation with people saying, no, get them a pass. Let them. No. If that's the case, then get these people who are out here killing people every day in our communities, get them a pass. Let them do what they're doing. Don't worry about them. It's a small percentage of the community, but y'all so worried about them, though. No, we have to be just as worried about these people. Because they don't have an excuse. They don't have traumas. They don't have poverty. They don't have all the issues that we have to worry about every day. They don't even have the damn reason to be as pissed off every day about somebody oppressing them or suppressing them as we do. But they out here acting a damn fool, killing people, running into buildings, destroying property. So I just hope that makes sense to y'all. I hope that makes sense to y'all. Make a lot of sense to me. So I appreciate, you know, everybody who's out here standing in solidarity and standing in unison. Dia, Dia. Dia, Dia. I see you, man. How's Aiden doing, man? Everybody make sure y'all send some support for Aiden. We have to revere, we have to respect and acknowledge our ancestors, those who have paid the ultimate price. What's good, young man? Who have paid the ultimate price for us to live in a more decent and fair world, which was their vision, which is what they gave their life for. Even if that's not the case, they still gave their life and effort for that to be, and effort for that to happen. It's cold. I don't deal with the cold. I wouldn't be out here otherwise. No, what I'm saying is, I don't care if it affects them. Listen, somebody not having a house to go to tonight don't affect me. But does that mean I shouldn't care? Why would I not care about that? Why would I not care because I got somewhere warm to live that the next person don't, because it don't affect me? That's the very fucking problem that we have in this country. So I don't have to be careful. They have to be careful. I don't have to do that. These are moral human things that should be, because we are born with these feelings. We are born with these emotions. We are born into a world with other people. So we have to care about what other people are doing. This is what you're describing is the American way. What I'm describing is the village way. Because the village gave a damn if somebody didn't have something to eat. They would make sure that person got something. Somebody would invite that person in. Because you know what happens if one of us don't have something to eat? That one person, their survival instincts will kick in and they will begin to take from the people who do have. That's why our communities look the way they do, because don't nobody give a damn as long as they eating. They don't give a damn. It has nothing to do with them. It has no effect on them. But not only does these things not affect them and they don't care, they are part of the reason, a major part of the reason why the things that don't affect them are happening to us. That is the main point. That is the main point. It ain't like we brought ourselves and put ourselves in this condition ourselves. Martin Luther King directly fought for the right to vote, for the rights of us to vote. These people right now are tearing this nation up because they don't want our votes to count. How directly? That is a direct attack on us. That is a direct attack on our rights. That is a direct attack on our ability to do the same thing that they went and did. They walked into a building or they mailed their ballot in and it counted, and they don't want ours to. So we're talking about the very fibers and fabrics that this nation is supposed to be built on and represent. But again, it's time over for hypocrisy in this nation. It's time over. If you're going to send the military out for decisions to not charge police, you're going to send armed forces out for people trying to protest, saying, don't kill us, let us, you know, go to jail at least and go through a process, then do that for people who are running in with the intention to kidnap, kill, and destroy people who are elected officials. I'm just saying, give them the same energy. That's all we're saying. Give them the same energy. We wouldn't have nothing to complain about. Give them the same energy. When a white male or a white woman pulls a weapon on a police officer, don't give them 15 minutes and tell them 58 times to drop it and then shoot them one time in the leg and steal, if even that, and take them into custody, because people have died for way less. People have died literally walking away or running away, shot in their back. Give them the same energy. That's literally all we ain't saying, and that's a danger to people, be that we're asking for that. People say, don't choke me to death. Don't, you know, shoot me in my back. Damn, at least just let me go to jail and get out. Like, give me the right to just even make it through the process. This stuff shouldn't even be asked for. So, MLK Day is not just about the death of one man. It's about what he represented and his message as well. Like I said, and that message has been about equality, unity, and equity. And that's what I'm talking about. That's what we're standing on. So we need more people to care. Because you can look around and you will absolutely see, you know, a lot more Europeans out here than you see us. And although that's something that needs to change as well, we appreciate them coming, standing in solidarity with us and saying these things. This is why our state, while the voting and everything changed and went our way. Not just us, it also was the people who empathized and sympathized with us as well. I'm not saying how they should think. This is not a thing about thought, you know, about their opinion. Their opinion about who they president, what party they represent, those are thought processes that I'm not telling them they should think the way that we want them to think then. I'm talking about humanity. This is not a thought. You're born onto this earth as one of 9+ billion people. You're not put on this earth for yourself. You're not put on it. That's just life 101.
This fight ain't new for me. I've been doing this for a while. I came here in the late 80s.
And you're regardless of what you're saying, at the very least, I want people to at least think that I'm another human being and my life matters. That's what they say, right? So it should matter enough to not kill me for no good reason.
Long good job, you know.
I know it's cold out here, but talking get way louder tonight. Make some noise for Martin Luther King, man.
Yeah!
And make some noise for y'all, because it's cold as a motherfucker out here, and we still out here fighting for one's life.
I want to thank everybody for coming out here, man. It's cold. We still gonna march. Y'all gonna march?
Yeah!
We got some speakers gonna come up here and say some words. And we just want to thank everybody for coming out.
You thank me?
We're both like, not me.
I didn't really come up here with anything prepared to say, but I did want to say that it's really important that we're out here. Every year, there's usually something hosted and there's a march around this, and we take some time to reflect on the activists that have come before us, people that have set the groundwork for the work that we do today. And it's important that we respect all the organizers here that are local to Milwaukee. I want to give a specific shout out to Lucille Breen. She's the first black woman to run for mayor here in Milwaukee, okay, and led the original Milwaukee Alliance in the 1970s. So give it up for Lucille.
Okay.
I also want to say that it's really important to support the youth today that have put on this rally. This is insane. I never would have dreamed of putting something on like this when I was 18. So give it up for the youth.
Yeah!
That's all I got to say. I'm going to pass it on to somebody else that's more prepared. Yeah. Oh, yeah, fuck the cops grant. They're voting on that tomorrow morning. We've all been doing a lot of work against that. They're trying to say that. You know, they're going to put these requirements that the police are supposedly going to follow. The pigs can't even listen to us, you know, when we tell them to stop killing black and brown people. So what makes you think that they're going to be listening to these 10 requirements put forth by the Common Council with no fucking accountability? So say no to the cops grant, call your alder people, and make sure that doesn't get passed through. All power to the people.
All power to the people.
Another person we want to shout out is Von Mays. Von Mays, been fighting. Von been fighting in the community for a while for change and making sure people with domestic violence situations is okay. So make some noise for him, y'all.
That ain't loud enough. Make some noise.
Much love to Brandon and the young people for being out here and inside us again. I see you, homie. Hey, it's so much we can say, but I appreciate every person who came out here in support, not just the young people, but to the vision and the, you know, fight and the ultimate price that Martin Luther King paid to put us here today. Somebody on my live asked, what do we think he would think if he was alive today? And if he was alive, that's the wrong question to ask. Because if he was alive today, that means from the point he died to now, we would have had his leadership. We would have had the leadership of somebody that we are missing between then and now. And I think we would be a lot further had we have retained some of those voices and those leaders that we lost too soon. But now we have new leadership coming up. We have Brandon. We have these young people here. We got Janaya, people like that. Who we can expect to lead us into the future. And we have to support them, and we have to do what we have to do to make sure that they don't have to fight the same fight when we are, they are my age and those older than me. We're sitting across from City Hall today. And like they said, the cops grant is up. Andre Nicholson, the club that he was killed at by a firefighter, is up, their license is up tomorrow for review. So we all need to be in unison and support against their license, as well as against that cops grant. So I just want to take a moment to put our fist in the air for our fallen Andre, because that's another fight that we have to deal with for his family and for against Site A, or Site A1, whatever it was called. We're in the park of Dontre Hamilton, who did not get any justice. And I find it, you know, I don't want to attack people, man, but it must be nice that if all lives matter, that more people ain't out here to celebrate the life of Martin Luther King. This is his day. Even if it's a day that they gave us, this is a day that his life should matter. And it must be nice to be able to just come out and skate around and enjoy the weather without a care in the world. But we out here together, we out here in unison. I'm gonna continue to fight. Every person out here, I hope to see y'all this time again next year. And power to the people.
Power to the people.
Thank you, Vaughn. Next speaker gonna be
I'm real strong.
We want to call up Christina Groppi. She gonna say a few words.
Woo! Christina Groppi, the daughter of Father Groppi.
Brandon, hey everybody. My name is Christine Groppi, for those who don't know me. My father was the Reverend Father James E. Groppi. He was a Catholic priest, advisor to the NAACP Youth Council and the Commandos, who participated in 200 nights of consecutive marches in Milwaukee for open housing in 1967 and 68. Many people might not know that during those marches, Dr. King actually sent his support here to Milwaukee in the form of a telegram to my dad, which is what I'm going to read to you today. September 4th, 1967. Reverend James E. Groppi, St. Boniface Catholic Church, 1122 West Street, Milwaukee. Your actions inspire me deeply. I have recently contended that those of us in the civil rights struggle must find a middle ground between riots and sentimental human complications for justice.
Sorry,
it means escalating nonviolence even to the point of civil disobedience if necessary. What you and your courageous associates are doing in Milwaukee will certainly serve as a kind of massive nonviolence we need in this turbulent time. It is possible to be militant and powerful without destroying life or property. Please know that you have my support and prayers. You are looking at the great tradition of the
righteousness. It's going in and out.
So I just wanted to share that with you since
thank you, thank you.
And maybe some of you didn't know that Dr. King was walking with us, but if you didn't know, now you know. So I want to thank everybody who came out and all of you, like our young people like Brandon, who are moving in Dr. King's tradition. I appreciate you guys. Love you guys. Thank you so much.
Yeah!
I, when I say his name, say Dontre Hamilton. Say his name.
Dontre Hamilton.
Say his name.
Dontre Hamilton.
Say his name.
Dontre Hamilton.
Make some noise for Mama Hamilton, y'all.
Yeah.
I want to thank everybody for coming out to support our warriors. These are our warriors. Y'all need to continue to pour into them. Martin Luther King had a dream, and they're bringing his dream to Florence because they're still fighting, and it's 2021. I love the movement. I love the revolution. I love to see our people come together. This is beautiful. But we need more. Y'all gotta stop living y'all houses by yourself. Bring other people with you. Because nobody is exempt. We've seen what happened on the 6th of January. They're mad as hell. When are we gonna get mad? When is enough gonna be enough? How many more people have to die? And while we're together, let's have a moment of silence for all our community members, all the people across the world who have died from this man-made pandemic. One moment, no conversation. The loss of life COVID-19 has taken. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
Dante's birthday is the 20th. And we're still here. We gotta change the laws, y'all. Nobody is immune for prosecution when you take a human life. Why are we here? If it don't matter, we have an opportunity because we have the Democrats in power in the House and the Senate. Use your voice. Call your representative. Call your senators. If they don't fulfill the needs of the community, y'all need to be talking to them. And they need to be out of office. Our city government sat up there in that building and watched Dontre lay on the ground. And they covered that shit up. Why they still in office? It don't matter what color they are. They're not doing their jobs for our community. And we have the power as the people of Milwaukee to get them out of those seats and put people in office who want to be there to serve our community.
Yes, ma'am.
Now's the time. We're being led by Martin Luther King. We're being led by love. And if you don't stand with us right now, you don't stand for nothing. Long live the revolution.
Long live the revolution.
Say his name, say Seville Smith.
Okay. So as y'all know, we won some seats in office. You know, our seats, they got the power. So we need to start lobbying. Right now, we need to start looking up laws that we can see changed in our favor. Right now is the time to put the ban on the police immunity. We can go to Tammy Baldwin's office. We can go to Gwen Moore's office.
Yeah.
We can go to Lena Taylor's office. We can go to Jonathan Brostoff's office. We can go to State Representative David Bowen's office. We can get laws changed in our favor. Yeah, they got mad and they act very uncivil. But at the end of the day, we just want an equal civilization for us all. Right. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna stay civil, and we're gonna make sure that the civil rights movement moves in our favor.
Right.
We're gonna make sure that the revolution begins and ends with us.
That's right.
So when I say I am, I wanna hear you say a revolutionary. I am
a revolutionary.
Long live the revolution.
Long live the revolution.
And we want to make sure we support Gideon with the guns, guns down, meal time. Stop the violence. It's time now. Next up, we want Khalil coming up.
Yeah.
Make some noise for these young people, make some noise! Yeah. I went to 6 different high schools. I really don't talk about my past too much. It took me a long time to get to a journey of growth and development. I used to self-educate myself when I used to skip school. I felt like school didn't apply to my everyday life. It didn't teach me how to survive day to day. I used to read books about the civil rights movement and about black people in the struggle and fighting for equality and justice in America. I learned about how gangs with America Call, formerly known as street organizations, used to march with Dr. Martin Luther King in Chicago. They were called his marshals. They protected Dr. Martin Luther King when he was getting punched in his face and water bottles and glass bottles was being thrown at him. The vice lords, the disciples and the stones was his protection. Right, but they don't teach you that. I learned this by reading. I also learned that in order for us to sustain a revolution, it must evolve. See, we must learn from the past as we move forward in today and think about tomorrow. What it says is, I remember Angela Davis was pretty much saying that the worst thing that she did not do in the revolution was give herself self-care. She said if she would have given herself more self-care, then they would have been able to sustain the revolution even longer.
That's right.
See, we must learn as revolutionaries how to have self-care in the revolution. See, the revolution must evolve over time. When you go back to our first 100 days of protest, revolution, it was different. And then we reached day 200, and it was different. And so then just got done talking about how the revolution must evolve into changing laws that Mama Hamilton was just talking about.
That's right.
That is evolution in the revolution.
That's right.
You must take the revolution to the next level.
That's right.
The only way that things change is if you change them.
That's right.
When we sit back and wait on circumstances or wait on the next name to be the nation's calling, then we already lost the battle.
Right.
See, we must be preventative. We must be proactive in the revolution. We must be able to put things in play that will stop things before it even happened.
Right.
That's how you change them laws. Change them laws.
Change them laws.
Change them laws.
Change them laws.
I love these young people.
Right.
And I just want to say thank you. Thank you to all of y'all for your growth. You know, y'all remember seeing them in the beginning? They grew so much. Right. Yeah, give them a round of applause. The last thing I want to share with you is when Dr. Martin Luther King, he was traveling all through the South. And everywhere he went, little Brandon, I want you to hear this. This is for you and you. Okay? But it's also for you. Dr. Martin Luther King was traveling all through the South. And he felt like his results was very slow in progress. He was getting arrested all the time. He probably got arrested over 50, 100 times, I think I read, Dr. Martin Luther King. Yeah, he got arrested that many times for justice. See, you got to be willing to fight for something.
Right.
But he felt discouraged. And it wasn't until the Children's March. Raise your hand if you heard about the Children's March.
Right.
Where over 500 children took to the streets and I think got arrested for justice. See, a lot of parents didn't jump right away to fight for justice. They stood on the sidelines, they heard about what was happening, but they didn't want to lose their job. They didn't want to sacrifice their family. They didn't want a cross burning on their front lawn. So they didn't fight. But when they see all of the children that went to jail, who was sprayed by water hoses, who was beat by dogs, who was beat by the motherfucking police, they had to do something.
That's right.
See, you got to do something when it's time to do something.
That's right.
And that's how you create the revolution.
That's right.
Long little revolution.
Long little revolution.
Make some noise for Victor, y'all.
Hey,
y'all.
Hey,
y'all. Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all. Hey, y'all.
Hey, y'all. Love y'all.
I wish King could see all of us together as we honor him today. If I ever got in trouble, y'all, I was just thinking to that this morning. I'm sitting on my bed and I'm thinking, if anything was to happen to me or my family, I know who would have my back.
That's right.
I know what community to turn to. I know what faces I would see show up. I know who has the courage and who is brave. I know who has the real spirit of love. That's what we exist for. To love, and I honestly and honestly love every last one of y'all.
Love you too, Becca.
No, you too.
I appreciate everybody who continues to show up. I appreciate everybody who continues to bring their skills, their passion, and manifest a movement together.
Right.
In order to move forward and to lift up names like Seville Smith, like Dontre Hamilton, like Joel Acevedo, like Alvin Cole, Jay Anderson, Antonio Gonzalez. I pray that one day y'all not gonna be lifting up Rebecca Burrell, but if y'all do, I know y'all gonna do it right. I love y'all. Everybody should be patting themselves on the back today because the dream didn't die. His dream didn't die. It's being made manifest. Things are gonna get worse in America. Y'all think y'all seen something at the Capitol. You ain't seen nothing yet. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put out a call to action, and the call to action is to continue to love on each other. Continue to lift each other up. Because collectively, we will continue in this movement. We will get justice, but not just justice, but we are creating a culture of love. And it's always justice in this culture of love. So if we can't get justice right away from them, we're at least giving each other justice unto each other. Y'all are beautiful people. You are raising up beautiful people around you. Somebody, you're touching somebody. Somebody is being touched by your life. Somebody is being touched by our lives from being together. This is inspiring. It's motivating. And it's saying that we won't shut up. We won't move around. And we won't lose. Because nothing is greater than love. And I believe that that was Dr. King's message. Darkness can't cast out darkness. Only light can do that. And I'm standing in the midst of light. I love y'all.
I'm gonna bring up Minister Khalid next. He's gonna say some words.
Peace, everybody. I said peace, everybody.
Peace.
All of us?
Or none.
All of us?
Or none.
All of us?
Or none.
Martin Luther King.
Can y'all hear me now?
Can y'all hear me?
No. Can y'all hear me? What about now?
Yeah.
Okay, great. Well, the late, great Martin Luther King said something that was very profound, and I always keep it with me, and I never forget those words. And the words that he spoke was, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere.
Right. And I live.
Yeah.
Can y'all hear me?
What about now?
Yeah.
Y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm afraid to move, so I can't really get into my groove, but I'm going to make this work, all right? But he said that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. And this is one of the reasons why I've traveled all over the country promoting and pushing justice and speaking truth to power. Because it's important that we understand our position as the people. The government can't run without the people. Nothing can happen without the people. And I liberate and I lift up the youth today for organizing issues and organizing actions like this, because it's gonna take the generations that's coming behind people like myself, Vaughn, and other people to make this fight continue on. We've been fighting this fight for over 150 years. So we know that it may not happen in our time to see true justice and equality and love for all happen and ring loud across this whole country. So it's important that we continue to build up our youth and keep them in position to carry on the fight.
Right.
Because we can't be disillusioned by what we believe to be possible. If that makes sense to everybody.
Yes, sir.
But I want to say this. The violence that's been perpetrated against our people in this country is unacceptable. The continued violence and racist regimes that are continuously perpetuating systemic racism and all forms of discrimination is unacceptable. And if you are a human being and you have a heart in your body, you can't stand by and do nothing about that. So I commend everybody that's out here right now that believe in the power of the people, because ain't no power like the power of the people, because the power of the people can't stop.
That's right.
It won't stop. And we won't allow it to stop. Because in the day that we live in today, we see very clearly the difference in the two Americas that we live in. We see one America where people can peacefully protest and one thing get damaged and they focus on the property instead of the people.
That's right.
We see another America where they can storm the White House and the Capitol and not one person get arrested on the site. No protection, no nothing. So we understand what the fight and the plight is against, that's happening against us right now. We have to be mindful that this fight is not going to end anytime soon.
Right, so keep
your boots strapped up, keep them tied up real tight, because we're going to keep beating up these grounds, beating up this pavement, and I don't want to hear another thing about property over lives.
That's right.
I don't want to hear it no more. Don't be trying to villainize the victims. The first thing happens when one of our sons or daughters get gunned down by police, they liberate their criminal history, the dysfunctionalities in their communities and their families before they talk about how they were victimized by the hands of an officer.
We got to stop allowing these people to shape our narrative. We got to control our own narrative, and we got to push our own agenda. We got to be able to speak truth to power, but when we speak truth to power, it has to be meaningful. We got to make sure that our demands are met. And if these elected officials can't push that agenda, we got to put our own people in position to push our agenda. All of us?
Or not.
All of us?
Or not.
All of us?
Or not.
We love you all. Peace and love.
Peace, peace.
We got one more person you want to bring up, Janaya. She going to say some words.
Come on, go on.
Okay, well, since it's Dr. King Day, I think it's only right I share my Dr. King speech with you guys. So I'm going to learn a little something. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was an activist committed to peace, justice, and equality for the oppressed. As a visionary leader of the civil rights movement, King fought for racial and economic justice for the oppressed. But still, after all that hard work and determination, we still see injustice, especially towards our Black community. So, let me break this down for you. We see these Black men unarmed, so why shouldn't they be alarmed when police are coming up to them, putting them in harm? Sorry, my bad, if I was taking it too far, but my people are disappearing faster than an agent from State Farm. I see the news and I flinch. Black people being shot down for sleeping on the bench. I can't breathe, just like I can't believe all these parents have to grieve. From Eric to Trayvon, everything's gone wrong, all because we forget that we were all made equal. Made is one, so why can't we find the strength to just put down the guns equal? All of God's people, put on this earth as brothers and sisters, misses and misters, unalarmed, unharmed, and unarmed. Unarmed, adjective, not equipped with or carrying any weapons. You heard that? No weapons. Innocent Black people didn't care when they aren't carrying weapons or trying to harm anyone. But then again, it's hard for us to be unarmed when they see our Blackness as a weapon. This is ridiculous. I shouldn't be afraid of being Black. I shouldn't be afraid that when I'm walking down the street, I'm going to get shot. I was told that when I would speak, then to speak, and not to let anyone make me be quiet. So right now, I'm ready to speak, and I need for you to listen. There is no reason why me being Black or anybody being different should be a problem to you. Dr. King said, if you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But no matter what you do, you have to keep moving forward. It is 2021. We need to keep moving forward. So I'll leave you with this. If not us, then who? We have to make a change now.
No, tell them how old you are. Tell them, people, how old you are. Hey, come on, man. Come on.
She's only 15. I also want to shout Aiden out. He's been taken off the heart machine.
Yeah. Dia, Dia.
I'm in the hospital. Y'all probably not going to hear me, but thank y'all.
We can hear you.
That's some noise for Aiden, y'all. Aiden the Great!
Aiden the Great!
Hey, we gonna get ready to march, y'all. So if you wanna, if you marching, march. If you gonna be in the cars, be in the cars.
March. Let's go.
Man, dog. I'm clipping that out, and I'm gonna tag her, and we posting just that. She is so dope to me, man. I swear to God, I wish that I could have been a part of this movement when I was that age.
We got a part two to this march.
Just to even have this group or have a group somewhere where I could have went to be involved in my own, you know, progress and my own liberation. I wish we had that when I was that age. I wish I had the mindset. I wish I had, you know, the platform to do that. Dia, Dia. What up, what up? Man, listen, man. No, we try to be all humble and slowly moving up. I think you got some media. How you doing? How you doing?
Good. How have you been?
I'm okay. How about yourself?
Good. Haven't seen you in a while.
How you doing? What's up? Oh, I'm like, who is this? How you doing? You want to? Yeah, Janaya.
Hi. I'm Allison.
Man, awesome ain't even the word. How you doing? Awesome is not even the word, dude. It's not even the word. Our young people enthuse me so much. And it's always one who is like shining so brightly. Dude, do y'all know what it's like to know somebody have all of that in their mind at 15 years old? Man, she... that's very inspirational. It's very inspirational, man. You know, so we gonna do what we can to lift her up. Make sure y'all support her when I make this post.
Who are driving? Can you please get in your cars?
When I make this post.
Can you please get in your cars? Y'all heard me.
One more time, bro.
If you want driving.
That is hilarious. Listen. Listen. Yeah.
No, I remember that.
How you doing, Jackie?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
I'm all right. Man, listen, man. So when I clip that part out and post it, and I put her information up there, y'all make sure y'all support her. Y'all make sure y'all hit her Cash App. Y'all make sure y'all support her however she needs. However she needs, we have to support our young people and what they are trying to do, what they are interested in, what their aspirations are, especially young people with that much talent. We cannot let them be out here maneuvering on their own and bumping their head unnecessarily. We cannot do that. We have to invest in them right now. And I want to continue to use my platform to help do that, man, because that's, listen, man, I promise it. If my daughter moves back up here, my daughter is 10 years old, she's going to be hanging around people like her. Not other 10-year-olds. She's going to be around people like that. You know, and I'm very, you know, these young people are my children because my children aren't physically here. That's a whole nother story. You know what I'm saying? But, oh, absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. She needs to start a huge social media campaign. You know, she really, YouTube, all that. You know, she needs to monetize herself. That speech, oh my God. And she has it memorized, oh my God. I'm just saying. So they finna get a little march in. So let me try to see where this is. Cause I don't want to end the live if I don't have to. You driving?
What time?
You driving the car? What's up? What's up?
What time?
We gotta talk, man.
Okay.
I'm for real.
I love y'all.
We gotta talk.
Okay.
Oh, that speech was right on. That was true.
I was in my room like this morning. I ain't gonna lie. I had a bad dream and I was like, I know who I'm finna call. Everybody showed up.
Listen.
Always. Yeah, I think the same thing. Like anything happen, I know who to call. I know what's up.
He has Sherman things, so either I can take it.
So I'm not gonna end the live. I'm gonna actually cover some of the protests for y'all. It's very rare that I get to come out here and be a part of these. One, because of the, y'all see, I ain't got no coat on again. I got a little sweater on, but y'all got big voices.
This shit like 3 weeks.
I'm media today. I get to cover the young people doing their thing. I'm media today. I get to cover the young people doing their thing.
I'm coming. Watch this.
Listen, man. Okay, so let me say this now.
It's cold as hell. That wind is cold. Man, listen. Dude, you did so. Oh my God.
Be out here looking like Frosty the Snowman. I need some snowman.
I'm gonna have to grab some of them damn fat ass. They got some more of them. Hold on, fam. What's up, young lady?
Hey, bro.
Oh, they took it in. It's too late. Damn. Get that blood flowing. What's good, bro? What's good, bro?
Good, good, man. Yes, I see those moments were happening, you know? Can't
tell anybody, man. Yeah, man.
Black Lives Matter!
I can't breathe.
Black Lives Matter. peace.
We don't want no racist
police.
We don't need no racist
police.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Justice.
When do we want it?
Now.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
Until we get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
Until we get it,
shut it down.
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 Shut it down. Who had a dream?
Martin Luther King.
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 No justice.
No peace.
No racist.
Police.
No justice.
No peace.
No racist.
Police.
Who had a dream?
Martin Luther King.
Who had a dream?
Martin Luther King.
Who had a dream?
Martin
Luther King. Who had a dream?
If
we don't get it,
shut it down.
Until we get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
Until we get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
Until we get it,
shut it down.
If we don't get it,
shut it down.
Until
shut it down.
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 Who had a dream?
Martin Luther King.
Who had a dream?
Martin Luther King.
Who had a dream? Don't arrest me.
Arrest the police.
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 Arrest the police. Convict the police.
Convict the police.
Indict the police.
Indict the police.
Don't arrest me.
Arrest the police.
Whose streets?
Our
streets.
Whose streets?
Our streets. Whose
streets? Our streets.
Whose city?
Our city.
Whose city?
Our city.
Whose city?
Our city.
Whose city?
Our city.
Who had a dream? Who had a dream? Who had a dream?
Do you know all the evil organizations in this building?
No.
That's the Institute for Law and Liberty, the Bradley Foundation.
Okay.
They're all in there, yeah.
Okay.
That's evil central.
Yeah. What up? We called us up. She drove my car. All right, y'all. Y'all make sure y'all say this. My finger's cold as fuck. So I'm about to end this live. And my battery about to die, I just see. All right, man. Peace and love.